We are here, my friends, my brothers and sisters, for another sharing of God's word to strengthen us and to remind us the teaching of God, the teaching of the Lord, to remind us to be aware of God's righteous judgment, of God's words, God's word. Tulungan tayo na intindihan natin ang totoong salita ng Diyos. To remind us to know the truth, to be in the truth, so that we can live according to God's will. We live in this difficult time, not easy time. Our prayers extended to Afghanistan, to our brothers and sisters. We cry for them. We are with them in their struggles. The people of Haiti and to the people who suffered in this COVID-19, the death of loved ones, doctors and nurses continue to fight. We need each other to be more empowered and to be more strengthened, because without God we can do nothing. Without God we cannot see what is right and wrong, what is righteous and will of God. That's why in here in my YouTube channel I continue to exalt the name of God, exalt the word of God. Sometimes maybe it can hurt you or it can offend you, but this is my call, this is my duty, this is my responsibility. Ito ang aking tawag, pangihatid ang katotohanan, to preach the truth. Because the world is different from God's will. It's hard to grasp the will of God without looking for God's word, which is apostolic, which is our guide that will reveal to us through the power of the Holy Spirit, will convince us, will talk to us, will communicate to us. Our Heavenly Father who give us the knowledge, the wisdom through our Lord Jesus Christ, who execute the acts of salvation, dying on the cross for us. Now let's talk this topic about God's wrath against sinful humanity. This is God's wrath, or another term, judgment against sinful humanity or a sinful world. We live in the sinful world, we live in a sinful humanity, and we need the word of God. And we should be rebuked, we should be corrected, we should be transformed, and we should be awake through the word of God, my friends, in order us to find the will, the true will of God. Let us pray. Lord, open our hearts and mind. Your words is the lamp into our faith and the guide into our. Sometimes your word is like a sword, will divide our soul and spirit, goes to our bone marrow. Lord, give us healing, give us the wisdom that we can be closer to you. Let your Holy Spirit indwell on us, shield us with your powerful love, so that we cannot come into your wrath and judgment. Open up our heart so that we can come to repentance when we commit sin. Open our soul so that we can come to you, Lord. Salamat po, Panginoon. Thank you, Jesus. Gracias a Dios po. Your love, O Lord. Amen. Amen. We're gonna read Romans chapter 1, verse 18 to verse 25. And let's talk about this. This is the word of God of Apostle Paul in the Christians of Romans. the early Christians in the time, and this is also our part of our spiritual enhancement, that we can be more closer to the teaching of our apostles, the teaching of our early prophets, and especially to our Lord Jesus Christ. The word of God says is here, verse 18 to 25 in Romans chapter 1. The wrath of God, this is being revealed from heaven against all the godlessness and wickedness of people who suppress the truth by their wickedness. Since what we may be known about God is plain to them, because God has made it plain to them, for since the creation of the world, God's invisible qualities, his eternal power and divine nature, had been clearly seen, being understood from what has been made, so that people are without excuse. For although they know God, they neither glorified him as God nor gave thanks to him, but their thinking became futile, and their foolish hearts were darkened. Although they claim to be wise, they become fools and exchange the glory of immortal God for images made to look like a mortal human being, and birds and animals and reptiles. Therefore God gave them over in the sinful desires of their hearts to sexual impurity, for being degrading of their bodies with one another. Verse 25, footnote, they exchange the truth about God for a lie, and worship and serve created things rather than the Creator, who is forever praised. And we will continue to read verse 26 and 27. Because of this, God gave them over to shameful lusts, even their woman exchanged natural sexual relations for unnatural ones. 27, in the same way, the men also abandoned natural relations with women and were inflamed with lust for one another. Men committed shameful acts with other men and received in themselves the due penalty of their error. The word of God, this time, this is hard, but this is the truth that will awake us in order us to know. This is a word addressed to the early Christians in the time of Romans, because the Christians is under in the Roman rule, and you know the Romans people, the Romanian, they have their different gods, and they apply pedophilia, having sex with men to men, women to women. They have sex with animals, they have sex with this kind of impurity that's here addressed by Apostle Paul. And there are many things that Apostle Paul want to discuss, especially the wrath of God. This is not like our human angry or human wrath. You burst. No, it's like a holy judgment. Not only for a judgment for the unrighteous, but here you can say that the wrath of God is being revealed from heaven against all the godlessness and wickedness of people. You can see, Apostle Paul, the godlessness, being unbelief of humanity, being sinful. You can see now what happened to the world. The world is so sinful. They don't want to hear the word of God. They don't want to be corrected. And if you preach about against them, they have right to kill you, to slap you. And even preachers are scared to their life. And this situation is like in a situation in the most difficult way to live in as a Christian. Afghanistan, Arab country, communist country, or this country who belong to worship, they are called pagans. They worship images like sun, birds, animals. You can see here that the wickedness of people, the sin that overwhelmed the world, and no one will determine what is right and wrong, because everyone want to enjoy their life. They want to do what they want, and they don't care about God's word. This is wickedness, humanity, sinful humanity. That's why it's Paul, Apostle Paul's word. Have you seen this to this time? Yes. The darkness of this world, the wickedness, because here God is being revealed from heaven against all godlessness and wickedness of people who suppress the truth by their wickedness. They suppress the truth. They don't want to know the truth. Remember, Jesus said, John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. You cannot go directly to the Heavenly Father without passing the Son of God, without passing Jesus. And people suppress this truth. They don't want to know the truth. In their wickedness, they suppress the truth. Since what may be known about God is plain to them, because God has made it plain to them. For since the creation of the world, God's invisible qualities of God, you can see here, His eternal power and divine nature, you see, invisible nature, qualities of God, that no one can explain, and His divine nature have been clearly seen, being understood from what has been made, so that people are without excuse. You see how God designed the world, designed the creation. See the sun, the moon, when God created, is a portrait of God's amazing creation. You can see how wonderful the world, but humanity, the people, through the influence of Satan who deceived humanity, we try to avoid and destroy it. And since here you can see that in the next verse, you can read that being understood from what has been made of God, so that people are without excuse. In verse 21, for although they know God, they neither glorify Him as God nor give thanks to Him. Human knows that there is God. You can say, you see now in the present time, you will ask people, yes, I know God, I know Jesus, I know the church, I know that, I know. But their actuation, their practices is not in the will of God. We're still swimming, enjoying sin, because they said it's God's grace, want to save us. We know that. But God's grace is not revealed or not a license in order us to disobey the will of God. Here, they know God, but their thinking become futile and their foolish heart were darkened. Their heart is darkened and full of evil. And although they claim to be wise, they become fools. This human never understand. And exchange the glory of God, the immortal God, for images. You see, people crying, hugging some statue, graven image. So when we praise God, you don't need images. You don't need those pictures. Because they are not real. They are not alive. We have a live God, a real God. You can feel God like a wind. Because God will live in your heart. Not the one you put in your room and you cry and you kiss. Hindi yung ribolto na dinadala-dala natin. Hindi po yan, sorry to say. But here, they change God in images. You see, it's an explanation to the pagan people, to the Gentiles, comparison to the Jews, comparison to the chosen people, and now as a Christian, are you still worshiping idols, worshiping images? That's even in the Ten Commandments, you shall not create or made any graven image. So here, you can see people exchange the real God into images and made look like a mortal human. You see, they put some images like a human. They said, and worship this, it can save you. You know, you remember those, the prince who died, I think prince in England. There is a tribe in other countries that they believe that he is God, and they made a statue to him, image, and worship him. Cannot do that. We cannot worship human. We cannot worship idols and images. We need to correct, because God is immortal. God in his quality. You cannot exchange God into images. God is powerful, omnipotent, and nothing impossible to God. He's present everywhere. You can put God in a little room or in a box. God is so wide, and no one can even explain. So here, they change the image of God into human and birds, animals, and reptiles. You see, some people worship cow, worship horse, sorry to say, worship eagle, worship monkeys, worship sun, worship moon, worship earth, and more. That's the practices of people who never come to Jesus, who never know God. Who never know God. The 24, therefore God gave them over in the sinful desires of their hearts to sexual impurity. This is a judgment because of the sinful heart of human rejecting the real God and disobeying God. God gave them the judgment to destroy their sexual impurity and degrading their bodies. And there, and with one another. And they exchange the truth about God to lie. They change the truth. They create, human create their own ways of life, their own way of decision. If you know, if you create by your own and not the will of God, it will be destroyed. Remember the tower of Babel. They want to reach God. They want to come to God. And then it's destroyed. nasira. Here you can see they change the truth about God to lie and worship and serve created things. They serve created things than the real God. Remember Meshach, Shadrach, Abednego? They never worship. I remember Daniel in the lion den, even in the time of the persecution. So I'm sure our brothers and sisters and the Christians in Afghanistan, I know Taliban tried to kill them, threaten them to surrender their faith. But they are like, I know they will be like Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego or Daniel. God will be with them. All of us who experience those hard things and worship and serve created things and rather than Creator who is forever praised. In verse 26, this is so serious. Because of this, God gave them over a sinful lust. This is a practice of sinful lust. Even their woman exchanged natural sexual relationship for unnatural one. You see, the woman, the result of this, the woman, they don't want to marry man already. And in verse 27, same way the men also abandoned natural relation with women and were inflamed with lust for one another. Men committed sinful acts with other men. Put note on this, with other men. And received themselves to the due of penalty of their error. You see, men to men, marrying men to men, marrying woman to woman, having sex, woman to woman, man to man. And according to here, in the Word of God, this is a sinful act. This is not condemning anyone. This is the Word of God. I am saying to you, this is Apostles Paul, Word of God, to remind the Christians in Romans, because the practice of Romans, they are pedophile, they are having sex with children, having sex with boys, and having sex with men and men, woman to woman. And this practices is a judgment of God. Look at the world today. Man will not enjoy woman anymore. Woman will never enjoy man anymore. It's a destroying part of life. As I said, I don't judge. I love everyone. But we should thank and know the Word of God in order us not to be judged by God. We have time to repent. We have time to surrender our life, to transform, to turn away from the wicked way of life. Let us meditate on this. This is a hard word. God's wrath against sinful humanity. Practicing worshiping idol, changing God into image, godlessness, not recognizing that there is God, enjoying lusts of the flesh and abandoning the reality. And that's the judgment of God. Again, verse 26, because of this sinful work, God gave them over a sinful lust. Even their woman exchanged the natural sexual relation for unnatural ones. And in the same way, men also abandon natural relation with women and were inflamed with lust for one another. Men committed sinful acts with other men and receive in themselves the due penalty of their error. Remember this. Verse 28, furthermore, just as they did not think it is worthwhile to retain the knowledge of God, so God gave them over to the free mind, so that they do not ought not to be done. They have become filled with every kind of wickedness. This you can hear. People filled every kind of wickedness. In verse 29, in Romans chapter 1, verse 29, they have become filled with every kind of wickedness, evil, greed, depravity. They are full of envy, murder, strife, deceit, and malice. They are gossips, verse 30, slanderers, God-haters, insolent, arrogant, and boastful. They invent ways of doing evil. They disobey their parents. They have no understanding of fidelity, no love, no mercy. Verse 32, although they know God's righteous decree that those who do such thing deserve punishment or death, they not only continue to do this, everything, but also approve of those who practice them. You see, this is the reality of the world. Not only in the time of the early Christians and in our time. I hope, my friends, let the word of God transform you. Do not be angry. If God, this word is powerful, dividing our soul, but this is the reality of the world. Murder, insolence, God's haters, slanders, murder, gossip, envy, depravity, disobeying parents. You can see here, our young people, it's true. Without God's word and the grace of God, we cannot see the will of God. My brothers and sisters, may the word of God transform us. It will hurt us, but this is the will of God. God intends us, discipline us, because He loves us. That's part of my sharing before. God bless you. May the word of God transform us all. Amen. Amen.